President, you may now resume
your line of questioning.
Council. Excuse me, Councillor. Because we are so pressed for time, if I may cut in just with two small questions, I believe it will save the time rather than rewinding in our minds, because it pertains to this period. Mr. Witness, could you clarify for the bench when did you become the Deputy Chief of Staff? Was it specifically, do you remember the year?
Answer. I cannot recall the exact year. It happened a long time ago. What I know is that it was after the conference held in Phnom Penh. That is what I know. Perhaps it was in late that year. It was late that year, in late 1975. It was between the mid and the late 1975.
Would this be then after the liberation of Phnom Penh?
Donc après la libération de Phnom Penh.
Or before?
Ou avant.
Answer. It was after the liberation of Phnom Penh in 1975.
One more question on this part of your testimony. You mentioned three persons who were aware of the weapons warehouse. Who physically amassed and placed the weapons there?
Je veux dire physiquement qui a procédé à récupérer ces armes et les y a entreposées.
Answer. I was the one who transported the weapon to that warehouse. And I was also the one who selected those who built the warehouse. I was referring to three tas or grandfather who were in charge of building that warehouse.
La juge Millard parle à micro fermé.
Is this then correct to understand that weapons were physically carried by other people?
Pouvons-nous en déduire que ce sont d'autres personnes qui ont
transporté in addition to you.
En plus de vous.
Answer. The weapons had been used by a lunar force.
Les armes utilisées par les forces de l'ONU.
Mic is not activated, Your Honor.
Le micro de la juge n'est pas allumé.
Who moved the weapons to the warehouse?
Qui a déplacé les armes? Qui les a apportées dans l'entrepôt?
Le témoin. Answer, I was transporting
c'est moi qui
the
ai
weapon.
Des
I was
armes.
The driver of
J'étais
the vehicle transporting all those weapons.
Du véhicule qui transportait ces armes.
Alone. Answer. The weapons were uploaded onto the vehicle.
Les armes ont été placées à bord du véhicule.
By the people at Chomka Chae Farm.
Par des gens
and as I stated, I was the only driver to the warehouse. And when I arrived at the warehouse, the three ta or grandfathers,
trois grands-pères,
transported these weapons. Into the warehouse and they were the ones who cleaned the weapons with oil.
Thank you.
La juge, merci.
Thank you, Judge Millard.
Merci, Madame la juge.
For sake of clarity, I will move a whole chapter now And come back to that later because of time reasons, the attack on Poussat and what happened at Portray. So I will come back to that. Mr. Witness, I'm asking you now questions. I'm going to ask you now questions as to the reasons behind the storage of these weapons. What was the rationale for storage in a hidden way of these weapons? What were you, Nim, and others supposed to do with these weapons?
J'aimerais savoir ce que Ronim et vous-même aviez prévu de faire avec ces armes.
Réponse. No one else could be able to use these weapons.
Personne d'autre ne pouvait utiliser ces armes.
He also used some of these weapons.
Ronim a utilisé certaines
de ces
armes.
As I stated, these weapons remaining from the wartime, they were war spoiled, used by the enemy, and I also used the weapons to fight against Pol Pot later on.
Ces armes pour lutter contre Pol Pot par la
was
suite.
That the original intention to
Question
hide these weapons
so
that Nim, you, and others could start an armed rebellion against
Pol Pot? Armée contre Pol Pot?
But answer.
Réponse.
There was no such rationale behind. I am not sure, but I was tasked to keep and maintain.
Je n'en suis pas certain, mais
weapons
on m'a demandé d'entreposer ces armes.
Warehouse.
I
was arrested by mistake two times in
1978.
And because of this, I made a decision that I could not stay and work for Pol Pot and Uranium.
Je ne voulais plus travailler pour Pol Pot et Uranium.
So I mobilized the remaining forces who were removed to work in the farm and in the plantation together so that we could protest.
Pour protester.
At the outset, some of these people were accused of stealing rice, so I could mobilize them and give weapons to them so that we can protest.
Mr. Witness, I'll move on a little bit. You
Merci,
have
témoin,
given testimony to the investigators of
Vous
the investigating judge that you, at one point in time, between 75 and 79, took with you thousands of Northwest Zone troops and started an armed rebellion against the center. Is that correct?
Est-ce exact?
Une remarque, Monsieur le Président, notre confrère
One comment, if I may, Mr. President.
Semble faire référence à des événements
Our
qui se sont passés en 1978.
Or,
le cas 2-1 concerne la période 75-77. Les politiques de l'entreprise commune sur lesquelles la Chambre de première instance s'est penchée s'arrêtent en décembre 1977. L'entreprise criminelle commune et sa composition s'arrêtent en décembre 1977. Donc il faut être clair à partir de maintenant, si nous commençons à poser des questions sur ce qui s'est passé après 1977, nous sommes complètement hors champ du procès 2-1. Nous avons un procès 2-2 uniquement dédié à ces questions, mais si nous commençons à déborder et aller au-delà de décembre 1977, cela ne sera d'aucune utilité pour la Cour suprême dans l'appréciation de l'appel. Je vous demande donc de demander aux parties de ne pas poser de questions sur une période qui ne correspond pas au procès 2-1.
Monsieur le Président, Mesdames, Messieurs de la Cour, je vous demande de bien écouter ce qui vient d'être dit par l'avocat des parties civiles. C'est capital. D'abord, décembre 1977, c'est une date qui a été fixée de manière totalement arbitraire par la Chambre de première instance pour la fin des deuxièmes déplacements de population. Mais surtout, ce qui vient d'être dit et le débat qui est en train de naître devant vous, c'est l'essence même des difficultés qui résultent de la disjonction. Et ce que vient de dire ma consoeur pour les parties civiles, tous les gens qui sont dans cette salle, ne sont pas forcément d'accord. Monsieur le procureur n'est certainement pas du tout d'accord avec cela. Et nous avons là un vrai problème. Je n'irai pas plus loin, nous avons développé tout cela dans le cadre de notre appel, mais il nous semble qu'en direct, à l'instant même, nous voyons les difficultés qui sont les nôtres.
Monsieur le Président, si vous me permettez de répondre deux secondes, parce que c'est effectivement important, je me réfère simplement au jugement dont il a été fait appel et sur lequel vous aurez à vous prononcer. Et le jugement est clair, à plus de 15 paragraphes, il est indiqué que les faits s'arrêtent en décembre 1977, les constatations de la Chambre sur les politiques de l'entreprise criminelle commune s'arrêtent en décembre 1977, que la composition de l'entreprise criminelle commune s'arrête en décembre 1977. C'est absolument limpide quand on lit le jugement.
The question seeks to explore the relationship of between the commanding structures of the Khmer Rouge, and we want to hear the answer. This dispute doesn't help us manage the time.
Thank you, Judge Millard. The question, Mr. Witness, was
je vous posais une question,
were these arms used by you and the 2,000 plus armed forces that you took into the mountains sometime between 75 and 79 to fight Pol Pot
pour lutter contre
and
Pol Pot,
the center, if you want to call it like this?
Le centre, si on veut l'appeler ainsi.
Your Honor, I object to the question. Counsel knows that the witness returned from China in 1977, and he, I believe, just stated it was 1978, after he was arrested twice, that he decided to go to the forest.
So,
stating 1975 to 1979, it's quite clear what the testimony is. It was 1978 and later.
Well, I don't think so. That is one of our core arguments. So that's why I formulated it neutrally, Mr. President, between 1975 and 79, the jurisdictional period. So I think I'm entitled to ask the questions relating to these 2 years, 75-79. So, Mr. Witness, did you and the troops that you took with you into the forest to start an open rebellion, did you use these weapons that you had earlier stored, these 20,000 weapons from the former Bono army?
Qui avaient été entreposés, comme nous l'avons entendu. Ces armes qui venaient de l'ancien régime de l'Olnol. Le témoin.
Answer. The weapons were not store secretly to start a rebellion against Pol Pot at the outset. We were told to keep these properly. After I was arrested twice by mistake, I went to search for who made the arrest.
And actually,
the chief of the children unit was arrested and he was
hit
until his head broken.
Il a été
2 days later, I could find a motorbike to go and ask my foster father.
Deux jours après, j'ai pris une moto pour aller voir
and I asked him why he told others to arrest me. He replied that he did not know about the arrest.
Qu'il n'en savait rien. Il n'était pas au courant de l'arrestation.
And I told him that if you were my foster father
dit,
and you were the superior and you did
si
not know about the arrest, that is
si
why
supérieur.
People in the southwest zone, some of them disappeared. And if you wanted others to arrest me, you could shoot me dead now.
Si
and I have other
rater,
ways to do the work.
Maintenant.
And after that time, I left the area. One week later, I was arrested again.
Une semaine après, j'ai été à nouveau arrêté.
And actually, the adolescent was arrested by mistake because they considered that adolescent was me. After this child,
c'est moi qui étais arrêté.
Pumping the water into the fields.
On m'a demandé d'aller
I went to ask my foster father again about
je
the arrest.
Suis retourné voir mon
and
père adoptif pour
he
lui demander
refused
si mon arrestation, mais il a
that he ordered
nié avoir demandé
someone to arrest me. At that time, I took out the gun and I took all the bullets and kept only one
and
I handed over the pistol to him so that he could kill me. And I told him that if he could not kill me with that bullet, I would kill him back.
Je lui ai dit que s'il ne me tuait pas avec cette arme,
at that time, my foster father told me that he was not the one who wanted to arrest his own adopted son. He said that it was the people from the center who wanted to arrest me. I replied and said to him that from now on, we no longer were foster father and adopted son, and I decided to defect the Ankar. At that time,
Pol Pot
was not used. The temple pot was not used.
À l'époque, on ne parlait pas
and
de Pol
I told
Pot.
Him that who followed and searched for me would be shot by me.
J'ai dit que j'allais tuer
my
ceux
foster
qui me
father explained me that I should not do anything in a rush.
Dit qu'il ne fallait surtout
and
pas
he
que
told
je
me
précipite.
To be patient. And I replied to him that I could not bear the situation because people were called into study session in Phnom Penh and they disappeared. And because of this incident, I started to think of taking 2,000 weapons to start the rebellion.
Mr. Witness, leaving aside for a moment the conflict, apparent conflict with your foster father, leaving aside the use of the weapons, leaving aside your arrest for a moment, do you know when plans were made for the first time
à quel moment il a été prévu
to rebel,
la première fois de l'ancien mouvement de rébellion.
Who was behind these plans?
Savez-vous qui se cachait derrière ce plan?
Answer. The rebellion plan was not behind anyone else. We had this kind of idea because we were thinking that we could no longer live in that regime. Many of our comrades disappeared. They were called into a study session in Phnom Penh and disappeared. And after I learned that they wanted to arrest me, and with hot help, I was not arrested. I started to think that I had to use that 2,000 weapons to start the rebellion.
I
implored Tapet Tanyum and other Tars to start the rebellion against Ankar at that time. I implored Tapet at his house. that he should be my superior in the forest so that we could start the rebellion together. He replied that he was old, he could not do that. I went to implore Ke and explain him that Anka wanted to eat their own children, and I told him I could not stay in the with Anka. I had to protest and start the rebellion, and I asked him to go into the forest, and he told me that he had to consult with others because he could not go. He could not go alone.
Mr. Witness, it's all very interesting what you're saying, but isn't it true, when I put that to you, that sometime in the summer of 75, August 75, your foster father, Nim, together with Sopim, Vornvet, possibly Koitun and others, started talking, starting having plans to openly rebel against the government, or the soon-to-be government. Is that correct?
Qu'en pensez-vous? Cela vous semble-t-il exact?
Can I say whether it was correct or not?
Je ne peux pas vous dire si c'est exact ou non.
However, after 1975, we met at the conference held in Phnom Penh.
Nous nous sommes rencontrés lors d'une conférence qui s'est tenue à Phnom Penh en 1975.
Location.
À Borei-Kilar.
And they were discussing the matter.
Ils en ont discuté.
In fact, there was no plan to rebel.
Mais il n'y avait pas de projet
de rébellion. Planning to demand the center for the people to return to their respective homes and villages.
Qu'ils acceptent que les
gens
rentrent chez eux dans leur village.
And that the money that had already been printed shall be put into circulation. That was the idea that we intended to bring forward to the center.
Voilà les demandes que nous voulions transmettre au centre.
And that was what I learned from their discussion during a meal time.
Qui ont eu lieu pendant le déjeuner.
That was according to you the goal of the ultimate rebellion.
L'objectif du mouvement de rébellion.
Is it correct that the means to
The witness did not confirm that the rebellion was discussed at the time.
Absolutely misstating the testimony.
If we could correct it.
I will rephrase, Your Honours. Were plans, do you know of plans at one point in time to assassinate Pol Pot, to sabotage the revolution by spreading chaos, both internally, externally, for instance by conducting a phony war with Thailand, ultimately to stage a coup d'état. Do you know anything about such plans, whether they existed in the second half of 1975?
Discuté dans la deuxième moitié de 1975.
Matt.
No, I was not aware of that.
Non, je n'étais pas au courant.
Have you ever
Question.
Heard of plans?
Avez-vous entendu parler
to combine forces from the east zone and the former north zone to attack Washington Airport, to attack the radio station, Radio Phnom Penh, at some time early
77?
No, I didn't know that.
Réponse, non, je n'étais pas au courant.
Do you have
Question.
Any recollection as to the role of neighboring country Vietnam, the role that Vietnam was to play in relation to an armed uprising?
Qu'il devait jouer dans ce mouvement de rébellion, de soulèvement?
No, I did not know about the matter with Vietnam,
non,
as I myself was based along the Thai border.
Moi-même, j'étais placé,
have you ever heard of a
Thailand?
Man,
question.
Vietnamese communist cadre called Hey So?
Avez-vous entendu parler d'un homme qui s'appelait Hey So, qui faisait partie des cadres communistes?
No.
Réponse,
the
non.
Name does not ring a bell.
Ce nom ne me
and
dit
you
rien.
Speak about Su. I heard of
j'ai entendu
that
parler
name.
De Su uniquement.
So at the lead.
But not So.
Mais pas So.
I apologize for
question.
My pronunciation,
pardonnez-moi
Mr. Witness.
Hey
Su,
so.
Does this name ring a bell to you?
Ce nom vous dit-il quelque chose?
You pronounce the name
Hai
Su. I'm not familiar with that name.
Je ne connais pas ce nom.
This Hai Su.
Question.
I'm trying to refresh your memory. Was a.
J'essaie de vous rafraîchir la mémoire.
Vietnamese expert in guerrilla warfare.
C'était
later
un
member
expert
of,
vietnamien au
the standing committee
conflit
of the Communist Party of Cambodia.
Appartenu au comité permanent
du Vietnam, excuse me.
Du Vietnam.
Does that ring a bell? Friend of your father?
Ce nom vous dit-il quelque chose? C'était un ami de votre père.
That's a leading question.
L'accusation.
It's suggesting
c'est
an answer and it has no basis.
Elle n'est pas fondée.
I'm first asking and I'm now trying to refresh his memory.
Does
that ring a bell, Mr. Witness, what I'm telling
you? S'il ne peut y répondre, Monsieur le témoin, cela vous dit-il quelque chose?
President.
Le président.
Defense counsel. Regarding
Maître.
The form of a leading question, please try to avoid it if you can.
I will, Mr. President, but I first asked it in an open way, and he said he didn't remember the name, and now I'm trying to indeed lead him a bit in the hope that it will somehow jog his memory. Mr. Witness, Hey Su, old friend of your father, Vietnamese expert in guerrilla warfare, him meeting with your father. Between 75 and 79. Does that ring a bell?
75 et 79. Cela vous rafraîchit-il la mémoire?
Between the period of 1975 to 79.
Réponse.
No. Since he had returned to his country since 1973.
En 1973.
Your father didn't meet him
question,
in
votre père ne l'a
May
pas rencontré 77. En mai 77.
No.
Réponse non.
Mr. Witness, let me read you
question.
An excerpt
Monsieur
from
témoin, j'aimerais
a statement
vous donner les clés
of
d'un passage, d'une déclaration
a witness
d'un témoin
who used to be your foster son, your foster father's, excuse me, bodyguard.
Le garde du corps de votre
Mr. Witness, Mr. President, excuse me. I'm referring to E319/19.3.107. English ERN 0097079, French 0104463, and Khmer 0096076. The question, Mr. Witness, put to this person who was somebody who was very close, it seems, to your foster father, is the following. On 17 April 75, where were you living and what were you doing?
Où viviez-vous et que faisiez-vous?
And he answers A3.
Sa réponse est la suivante.
On 17 April 75, I moved to live in Kangat until 76, when Tanim invited me to be his bodyguard. I was his bodyguard until he was arrested. I escorted and secured his safety everywhere he went. He had three bodyguards, including me, but I was not the one who got in the car with him. I used to escort Tanim to Phnom Den Mountain, which is bordered by Vietnam. Question. Why did you escort Tanim to Phnom Den Mountain?
And then
he answers, he needed me to secure him while he was transporting military uniforms from Phnom Den Mountain to Ampil Prahong and Sisophon in 1977. Sisophon was also Tanim's military base. Question, what place was Ampil Prahong? Ampil Prahong answer was Tanim's house and office.
Ampil
Prahong was 1 kilometer west of Psalu Market. Question, what were those military uniforms transported for?
Answer,
I did not know for whom those uniforms were transported, but Tanim told me those uniforms had come from Vietnam. Were you fetching the uniforms from Phnom Den Mountain? Was there fighting along the Vietnam border yet? There had not been any fighting yet. Now, Mr. Witness, a little further down, he is being questioned by security people as to the reasons why your foster father was receiving uniforms, military uniforms from Vietnam. Do you know anything about that?
On lui demande pour quelle raison. Avez-vous une idée de cela vous-même?
No, I neither knew nor saw anything.
Non, je ne sais rien à ce sujet.
And the uniform.
Je ne sais rien par rapport à ces uniformes.
The clothes were produced from a textile factory in
Les vêtements étaient produits
and
dans
we
une usine de textile de
Battambang. Natural tree resource.
On utilisait
in
des
Cambodia.
Arbres cambodgiens pour
we
la teinture des vêtements.
Tree bark to dye the clothes. But I never heard about those
Mais j'ai jamais entendu parler de ces
overseas.
Uniformes qui venaient d'ailleurs, de l'étranger. Question.
Mr. Witness, did you know at the time, or maybe later when you were studying in the Soviet Union, or later when you were working closely with Vietnamese military troops, that in February 1978, the full plenum of the Central Committee of the Vietnamese Communist Party decided to start an internal uprising led by Soe Pim, and if that wouldn't work, ultimately to invade Cambodia. Have you heard at the time anything about that, or have you heard while you were in the Soviet Union anything about that?
Mr. President,
Remarque, est-ce qu'on peut savoir d'où notre confrère tire cette information?
Qu'il
a déjà essayé d'utiliser dans le procès 2-2, il a été incapable de nous fournir la source. Est-il possible qu'on comprenne d'où cette information est sortie pour que nous puissions éventuellement la regarder, la lire, la contredire, poser éventuellement des questions aux témoins sur cette information? Nous ne savons absolument pas d'où cela sort.
Your Honor, my objection is different. It is absolutely irrelevant to the appeal of 2-1. Now we're getting into whether Vietnam had plans in 1978 to invade Cambodia, and it's clearly beyond the scope of the issues in case 2-1, which, as my colleague previously pointed out, the temporal scope ends in 1977.
Mr. President, if I may reply, it's the two objections are, I suppose, both troubling on various levels. Troubling is that civil party lawyers still does not seem to know, which by now is common knowledge, that this decision was made in February 78. It is documented extensively by the court's expert, Nayan Chanda. He wrote about it in 78-79 in the Far Eastern Economic Review. He wrote about it in his book, which was extensively discussed in the first trial. Other scholars have confirmed this. I don't think there's any doubt whatsoever that this fourth plenum did indeed come together in February 78. In relation to the objection of the prosecution, I have no idea how to put that in any perspective. I think the decision of Vietnam is crucial. The role of Vietnam is crucial to understanding anything as to what happened in DK between 75 and 79. It's certainly not outside the scope of this trial. I would just like to remind you that although the severance decision is an incomprehensible one, there's no doubt about that. If you go, and that is the reality, to the actual judgment, the last document, I actually did some research this weekend, the last document in time that was used by the trial chamber dates from January 79, which is a communications to the United Nations. There are many documents, S21 documents, which date all the way to August 78. So now to stand up and pretend like this is a severance issue or outside of the scope issue is ridiculous. I'm sorry to use that word again.
Mr. President.
President,
it is the chamber's observation that the ground raised by the defense counsel that you have a reference to refer to. However, the fact mentioned in your question is not related to the facts in this appeal proceedings. Although it has something to do with the Vietnamese. Please move on with the other questions that you may have, but make sure that your questions fall within the scope of today's appeal proceedings. Thank you.
Le champ des, de l'appel. And
if you have a document number,
to answer that first question, of course, Mr. President, we put on record E3/2376, English ERN 00192401, French 00237080, and in Khmer 00191550. That's an excerpt from Nayan Chanda's book called Brother Enemy. So we did document this decision beforehand, Mr. President. In relation to the question in itself, I have noticed that you have given a decision without consultation of the bench. This is such a principled matter for us. I would like you to confer with your fellow judges and to reason and argue about this question that is very crucial to us. And if you forbid me, then so be it. But I would like you to have a debate within the chamber.
Regarding
the matter that you raised, in fact, the chamber does not object your question,
ne s'oppose pas à votre question.
But make sure you refresh your questions.
Vous assurez
and that your questions should not focus on the facts that are outside the temporal jurisdiction of these appeal proceedings. That is all what the Chamber wants.
Then I apologize for not understanding well your decision, Mr. President. Let me rephrase, try to rephrase my question. Mr. Witness, were you at the time or later while you were in the Soviet Union aware of a February 1978 decision of the fourth plenum of the Central Committee of the Vietnamese Communist Party to start an internal rebellion led by Sao Pim, and if that would not work, to invade democratic Cambodia? Do you know anything about that?
No, I don't.
Réponse. Non.
When you were in the Soviet Union studying at the military academy, were you ever being taught about the Soviet invasion of Czechoslovakia in 1968?
Enseigné ou parlé de l'en de quand l'Union soviétique envahit la Tchécoslovaquie?
Yes, I went to attend that study course. However, it was not about the invasion. It was focused mainly about the military strategies, mostly about the administrative work at the general staff and how to manage soldiers. We did not touch on the issue of the incursion or invasion at all.
Mr. Witness, let me read to you minutes of a meeting of all commanders of the Central Armies, minutes of the meetings of October 76, led by Son Sen, Mr. President, E3/13, English ERN 009-40343, Khmer 00052406. And French 00334976. Now Son Sen is addressing all commanders of the center's divisions, and he says the following, and I quote: "The enemy to the east, the key plan of the enemy of the east, the Vietnamese, with the Soviets behind them, was to attack from the inside through the traitorous forces of Ya, Kiumas, Chuk and Chakrai. What they would have liked in terms of an attack from the outside was to attack in Czechoslovakian and Angolan style. But this was merely a morale boost, because given our situation, this was not something the enemy could do. Have you ever heard something to that effect in 76, Vietnam suggesting, maybe to your father or others, that Vietnam would do a 68 kind of Czechoslovakia style attack?
Un peu comme les Soviétiques avaient fait en 68 en Tchécoslovaquie.
No, I never heard about that.
J'ai jamais entendu parler de cela.
The same expert of this court, Nayan Chanda, wrote in his book that he had talked to a Vietnamese general in 78, who told him that in fact this had been the advice of the Soviet Union to Vietnam in early 78. Do you know anything about this? Were you ever told this while you were at the military academy in the Soviet Union?
Alors que vous étiez à ce collège militaire en Union soviétique. Réponse.
I have already stated my course.
Non, je vous ai déjà dit que les cours que je suivais
involve the strategies that we would use for our armies to defend our territory and how to use the weapons effectively, and besides that, the course did not focus on anything else.
Witness, let me read to you an excerpt from another Northwestern cadre. Mr. President, that would be E319/13.3.58, English ERN 009-70467, French 009-74761, and Khmer. Khmer 009-47282. Question. Did you know, question 13, by the way, did you know why the Southwest cadres came to replace the Northwest cadres? They had been accused of being affiliated with the Viet Minh Khmer Rouge and the East Zone Committee, Chief Sao Pim. These two zones had turned against Pol Pot. According to my observations, the Khmer Rouge was apparently composed of three or four groups. The first group was the Viet Minh. The second group was the nationalistic Khmer Rouge. The third was the Sihanouk Khmer Rouge. And the fourth group was the Khmer Rouge from China, including Pol Pot. Now, Mr. Witness, this fellow Northwest Song cadres is speaking about various factions within the CPK. Is that your recollection as well?
Est-ce que cela correspond à vos souvenirs?
Mad Bob, y pâti chan, y mien menai, gapan la rung à la tuk pi nia day tau.
It might have happened due to the number. However, as for the replacement of the Southwest group.
Pour ce qui est du fait que le Sud-Ouest est venu remplacer.
To the Northwest group, I did not know because the people had been arrested and sent away, and I did not know the details.
Were you, in fact, yourself a member of one of those four factions backed by Vietnam, which was trying to rebel and start an armed conflict with the group led by Pol Pot?
Le groupe de Pol Pot et lancer un conflit armé.
You can say I was in one of the four factions.
Vous pourriez dire
However,
que je faisais partie
as
de ces quatre
I said
factions.
Earlier, if I had not been arrested and no attempt was made on my life, I would not involve
si
in the activity
arrêté,
of what
si
I did.
Personne n'avait cherché à
After.
Me tuer, je n'aurais jamais participé à ces activités.
I saw children who were parentless and
Moi, j'ai vu des
I fostered them.
Orphelins.
And I myself was alleged of being slaves to the Vietnamese.
On
In fact, I did not have anything at all to do with the Vietnamese during the period.
I
myself was based along the Thai border.
Moi, j'étais au bord de la frontière Thaï,
I dealt
avec la Thaïlande
with
plutôt.
The Vietnamese during the 1970, but by late 1972 and 1973, the Vietnamese had left. And I no longer had any contact with them,
avec eux.
And I'd like to make this clear to the chamber.
But did Sao Pim or Runim, your foster father, or Chakrai, or Koytun, or Tiff all have any contacts with the Vietnamese?
Tous ces gens avaient-ils des contacts avec les Vietnamiens?
In this rebellion.
Dans le cadre de cette rébellion. Réponse.
I was not aware of that.
Mr. Witness, I would like now to turn to you, your arrest that you just briefly described already. Mr. President, as you have noticed, I'm already busy for 2 hours, but I need some substantial more time, which this time I don't think can be solved with giving the defense 10 minutes extra. So I would kindly ask your permission to continue questioning this witness after the lunch break for another hour.
Your Honors, we would ask the court not to grant that for a simple reason. This is not a retrial. Counsel's raising issues that are completely irrelevant. He's wasted his time talking about Czechoslovakia in 1968 and what this witness studied in the 1980s and hasn't gone to any issues that are really on appeal. So it's, if there's a problem with time, it's because the defense has not focused on the appeal issues.
L'avocat ne s'est pas concentré sur les questions relatives à la peine.
President, and based on our discussion and deliberation, you may now continue for 10 minutes.
Nous vous accordons 10 minutes de plus, ou plutôt, nous vous demandons de poursuivre pendant encore 10 minutes.
President, you may now resume your line of questioning, counsel.
10 minutes, that's what I get. Very generous, thank you, Mr. President. Mr. Witness, you said earlier that you had been arrested at one point in time. What happened after your arrest? Where were you detained?
Que s'est-il passé après votre arrestation? Où avez-vous été détenu?
Answer.
Réponse.
The attempt to arrest me first time
ils ont
failed.
Cherché à m'arrêter la première fois, mais ils ont échoué.
They arrested another one by mistake.
C'est quelqu'un d'autre qu'ils ont arrêté.
At that time, I was riding the bicycle, and the chief of the children unit was behind me, and they arrested that chief.
Donc ils ont arrêté ce chef.
He was taken away and tortured.
On l'a torturé.
And it was a mistake that the person was not me. And for the second time, the chief of the pumping water unit was arrested by mistake.
Where were you detained after your arrest, Mr. Witness?
Question. Où avez-vous été détenu, Monsieur le témoin?
Réponse. I told you already that the attempt to arrest me failed, and they, in fact, arrested my deputy, and he was not taken anywhere. He was hit and tortured.
On l'a battu, on l'a torturé.
And when they realized that it was the mistake to arrest that person,
ils l'avaient arrêté par erreur.
He was released, and after he released, he sustained blood on his head, and I tore chroma to wrap around the wound.
Sur la tête, et je lui ai donné un chroma pour qu'il se le mette sur la tête.
At that time, the arrest failed.
Mais ils n'ont pas réussi à m'arrêter.
Let me interrupt you, Mr. Witness. Let me read to you a passage from this Northwest Zone cadre who I referred to earlier. Mr. President, that is document E319/13.3.17, English ERN 0098422, French 0100-4436, Khmer 0095-1906. Question. You talked about Taham. What was Taham's position during the Khmer Rouge regime? Answer. Taham was deputy of the zone military general staff. He was Takleng's deputy. Question. Do you know what happened to Taham? Answer. Taham was also arrested. They were arrested together. I obtained information that both divisions of the Northwest Zone had planned to fight back against Pol Pot. But this plan had been leaked through some agents of the center. That was why the military people were arrested. Taham was accused of having transported military equipment to Phnom Bia Chap Mountain. I learned about this after 79 from a driver who had transported the equipment in question. Another soldier told me of a hearing their leaders say in a meeting that if nothing was done about the Northwest group, the zone would revolt like the East Zone. Mr. Witness, were you arrested together with Kleng? And were you accused of having transported military equipment that we just discussed?
Ces mêmes armes dont nous avons parlé tout à l'heure. Réponse.
Answer. The attempt to arrest me failed. And as for the weapons,
ne m'ont pas arrêté. Ils ont échoué.
The weapons, as I said, was not stored the rebellion against Pol Pot. And the attempt to arrest me once again failed, and for this reason, I decided to use the weapons to start the rebellion against them.
Mr. Witness, after your arrest, how many men did you lead into the forest to start openly an armed conflict with the center's troops? When exactly was that?
At first, nine of us
went
to the cooperative. We considered ourselves thieves to steal rice to eat.
Nous considérions que nous étions des voleurs parce que nous volions du riz pour le manger.
After I hit those people from 108, after I attacked them,
caché les gens de 108.
And at that time, the mobile units and other units chief were going with me, and it was like the encouragement for me and for my group.
Cela nous encourageait, moi et mon groupe.
Mobile unit people and other unit chief said that they would die if they did not revolve. That is why that we together went to the warehouse to collect the weapons.
Mr. Witness, let me interrupt you. Let me summarize your own testimony to the investigators and then tell me if I summarize it adequately. Did you at one point in time flee into the forest with 2,000 men and that all sectors of the Northwest Zone came under your control except Sector 7,
that
you started open fighting against Southwest Zone troops, and that at one point in time you liaised with troops from the East Zone led by Heng Samrin?
Qui étaient, eux, dirigés par Heng Samrin. Réponse.
Answer. This struggle did not have a proper structure. As I told you already, there were only nine of us at the beginning, but later on, other people joined us, and it was convinced that we could have strong force to fight against them, and I went to encourage the old soldier who were assigned to cut trees and work at different places so that we could be together to rebel. And I could be able to mobilize 2,000 people to join with me.
And at one point
in time, did you contact the East Zone forces led by Heng Samrin? Did you, together with his forces, attacked former Southwest Zone forces? Is that correct?
De l'ancienne zone sud-ouest, tous ensemble. Est-ce exact?
Answer. Réponse. Regarding the contact with Luc Da Heng Samrin, who was a part of the United Front of Cambodia, happened after the troops of United Front arrived in Battambang.
At the outset,
I thought it was only my troop who would revolt, but actually there were others
who
wanted to revolt as well, and we were thinking that we would fight along the way with what we had.
Lutter avec ce que nous avions à notre disposition.
And later on, after we were fighting with the regime, many people joined our force, and many other troops rebelled against the regime as well. And there were forces from Phnom Penh, there were Pansovan force, GSM, Hazelman forces, and by that time, all the force of United Front of Cambodia had arrived in Battambang already. I contacted these forces in Battambang, not at the East Zone.
I have many more questions to you about this open-armed conflict, Mr. Witness, but my last question will be about the arrest of your foster father, Ronim. There is a witness who testified before the investigators that your foster father learned about his pending arrest, escaped to Sisyphone and was arrested in Sisyphone by armed units using a helicopter. Is that correct?
Answer. I do not know
réponse,
about
je ne sais
that.
Pas.
At that time,
je
there was no helicopter.
À l'époque, il
n'y
avait pas
de,
d'hélicoptère.
And parts of helicopter were used for
les pièces
to make the tools, and I do not know about
pour
that.
Des donc, je n'étais pas au courant.
Thank you, Mr. Witness.
Question,
Mr. President,
merci,
for the
témoin.
Record, I have not asked any questions to the witness yet about the attack 75 on Pursat. Provincial town, what happened with the soldiers at Toul Portray. So maybe if I make my request very specific and ask for permission for about 20-25 minutes to only ask questions in relation to the attack on Pursat provincial town and what happened subsequently to the soldiers working for or fighting for the Lon-Nol regime.
Le président.
Let me clarify once again.
Permettez-moi de préciser, maître.
You fostered once an additional 10 minutes, and then you requested to have
10 minutes supplémentaires. Ensuite, vous avez demandé d'avoir une heure de plus.
And now, you are
maintenant,
requesting for another 20 to 25 minutes.
20-25 minutes
so your 20-25 minutes as requested can give you time to complete your
dans ces
20-25
overall minutes supplémentaires, vous pourrez
so
poser
how many
le reste
time
de vos questions. Mais j'aimerais
exactly
savoir combien
now
de temps vous
maybe something went wrong in the translation, Mr. President. I asked for an hour.
Merci, Monsieur le Président. Il y a peut-être
eu un problème d'interprétation. J'ai demandé
une heure supplémentaire. Vous avez décidé de m'accorder 10 minutes.
So maybe that wasn't clear. What I'm asking now is another 20-25 minutes,
maintenant,
and I will,
20-25
I promise, limit myself
pour,
to questions in relation to Pursat and the attack on Pursat, and what happened at Toul Portray.
Et sur ce qui s'est passé à Toul Portray.
Chef, je vous remercie pour votre temps.
Le président.
Now, you are asking for another 20 and 25 minutes. So
20,
this can conclude
à présent,
all your questions by
pensez-vous que
giving
cela vous
you 20 to 25 minutes.
De vos questions.
Yes,
Maître Copé. Oui, Monsieur le Président.
Thank you very much.
Merci beaucoup.
Mr. Witness, let me take you back now to March, April 75.
Monsieur le témoin, revenons
what do you remember
75,
of the attack?
Si vous vous souvenez,
hello.
Le président interrompt.
Council,
maître,
I think we should take a lunch
je
break
pense qu'il
first.
Faut faire la pause déjeuner.
And the request, your request to have another 20
vous avez demandé,
to 25 minutes,
de 20-25 minutes
in addition to the time that we have just given,
outre le temps supplémentaire que
will
nous
be
vous avions déjà accordé,
discuss and decide
nous
during the lunch
rediscuter
break.
Pendant la pause déjeuner.
Now the chamber would like to take lunch break first.
Nous souhaitons à présent faire la pause déjeuner. Le juge Millard.
To both counsel of the defense, considering the course of the of the interviewing of the witness so far and the interest of the clients, would you be capable of agreeing as to the use of time after the break for the defense?
Je ne comprends pas bien votre question, madame le juge. Effectivement, il est possible qu'il me reste du temps de disponible à la fin des questions, et à ce moment-là, je laisserai ce temps disponible à mon confrère de Toeun. Tant que je n'ai pas entendu les questions qu'il a l'intention de poser sur sujet qui m'intéresse aussi beaucoup, c'est un peu difficile de voir,
I
mais je ne reposerai pas les mêmes questions
to ask on a subject that I'm very interested in, so it's difficult to foresee, but we do not, I shall not do my best not to overlap with questions already put.
Yeah, we were asking because we know that we are behind the schedule. We started later, and also we remember that there was a request from the prosecution and the civil parties for the additional time, so which we turned down. But in light of the how the questioning goes, we would need to consider this as well. So we just wanted to have all this data before we go to break to decide on the timing issue.
Thank you, Judge. I will limit myself to 20-25 minutes, and then we'll hand the floor to the PS1 defense team, and they can round up their time totally allotted to the defense.
President, thank you. Now, the court will take a lunch break, and security personnel are instructed to bring the two accused to the waiting room, and please bring him back at 10:20. The court is now adjourned. 1:20 rather.
À 13:20.